girls gives up one lunch recess a week to practice, which when you're in fourth and fifth grade, that's a really big deal. So thanks, boys and girls, because I know it's been a really nice November, and sometimes it was hard to stay inside to practice, but I'm sure you'll agree that they sound fabulous. So please enjoy How the Grinch Stole Christmas.
Christmas a lot. But the Grinch who lived just north of Whoville did not. The Grinch hated Christmas, the whole Christmas season. Now please don't ask why, no one quite knows the reason. It could be his head wasn't screwed on just right. It could be, perhaps, that his shoes were too tight. But I think that the most likely reason of all may have been that his heart was two sizes too small.
Thank you.
but whatever the reason, his heart or his shoes, he stood there on Christmas Eve, hating the Who's. Staring down from his cave with a sour, grinchy frown at the warm lighted windows below in their town. For he knew every Who down in Whoville beneath was busy now hanging a mistletoe wreath.
And they're hanging their stockings,
he snarled with a sneer.
Tomorrow is Christmas. It's practically here.
Then he growled with his clenched fingers nervously drumming.
I must find some way to stop Christmas from coming.
Tomorrow, he knew. All the Who girls and boys would wake bright and early. They'd rush for their toys. And then, oh the noise, oh the noise, 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 noise! That's one thing he hated. The noise, 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 noise. He hated the noise, 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 noise.
Thank you.
and gentlemen, the fourth graders are going to be entering and the fifth grade is going to be leaving. So if you could please clear those center aisles. And we do have two single seats up here in the front. There's one right here and there's one over here.
Oh. We have them start going down. Oh, those in fourth grade. Never mind. Okay.
I know. I was thinking.
Thank you.
Grinch thought of this Pooh Christmas sin, the more the Grinch thought,
I must stop this whole thing. Why, for 53 years I've put up with it now. I must stop this Christmas from coming. But how?
Then he got an idea. An awful idea. The Grinch got a wonderful, awful idea.
I know just what to do.
The Grinch laughed in his throat, and he made a quick Santa Claus hat and a coat. And he chuckled and clucked.
What a great Grinchy trick! With this coat and this hat, I look just like Saint Nick. All I need is a reindeer.
The Grinch looked around. But since reindeer are scarce, there was none to be found. Did that stop the old Grinch?
No, the Grinch simply said. If I can't find a reindeer, I'll make one instead.
So he called his dog Max. Then he took some red thread and tied a big horn on top of his head. Then he loaded some bags and some old empty sacks on a ramshackle sled, and he hitched up old Max. Then the Grinch said, "Get up!" And the sleigh started down toward the homes where the Whos lay a snooze in that town.
Number one,
the old Grinch God's kiss, and he climbed to the roof
empty bags in his fist. Then he slid down the chimney, a rather tight pinch. But if Santa could do it, then so could the Grinch. He got stuck only once, for a moment or two. Then he stuck his head out of the fireplace flue, where the little hoo stocking all hung in a row. "These stockings," he grinned, "are the first things to go." Then he slithered and slunk with a smile most unpleasant around the whole room. And he took every present, pop guns and bicycles, roller skates, drums, checkerboards, tricycles, popcorn and plums. And he stuffed them in bags. Then the Grinch, very nimbly, stuffed all the bags, one by one, up the chimney. Then he slunk to the icebox. He took the Who's feast. He took the Who pudding. He took the roast beast. He cleaned out that icebox as quick as a flash. Why, that Grinch even took their last can of Who hash. Then he stuffed all the food up the chimney with glee. "And now," grinned the Grinch, "I will stuff up the tree." "Sweet little tart," the fake Santa Claus lied. There's a light on this tree that won't light on one side. So I'm taking it home to my workshop, my dear. I'll fix it up there, then I'll bring it back here.
And his fib fooled the child, and he patted her head, and he got her a drink, and he sent her to bed. And when Cindy Lou-Hoo went to bed with her cup, he went to the chimney and stuffed the tree up. Thing he took was the log for their fire. Then he went up the chimney himself, the old liar. On their walls he left nothing but hooks and some wire. And the one speck of food that he left in the house was a crumb that was even too small for a mouse. Then he did the same thing to the other whose houses, leaving crumbs much too small for the other whose mouses. It was 11:15. All the whose still abed, all the whose still asnooze, when he packed up his sled. Packed it up with their presents, the ribbons, the wrappings, the tags and the tinsel, the trimmings, the trappings. Feet up the side of Mount Crumpet, he rode with his load to the tip-top to dump it. Poo, poo to the hoos, he was grinchishly humming. They're finding out now that no Christmas is coming. They're just waking up. I know just what they'll do. Their mouths will hang open a minute or two. Then the hooves down in Hooville will all cry boo and boo. That's a noise, grinned the Grinch, that I simply must hear. So he paused, and the Grinch put his hand to his ear. And he did hear a sound, rising over the snow. It started in low, then it started to go up. But the sound wasn't sad. Why, this sound sounded merry. It couldn't be so, but it was merry. Very. He stared down at Whoville. The Grinch popped his eyes. Then he shook. What he saw was a shocking surprise. Every who down in Whoville, the tall and the small, was singing without any presents at all. Who down in Whoville, the tall and the small, was singing without any presents at all.
Say that the Grinch's small heart grew three
three sizes that day. And the minute his heart didn't feel quite so tight, he whizzed with his load through the bright morning light. And he brought back the toys and the food for the feast, and he himself, the Grinch, carved the roast beast.
Bye. down, it's morning, and the nuclear summer series has begun.